गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस ऑफ आरसे एजुकेशन हब एंड लेट वी स्टार्ट क्लास 12 चैप्टर नंबर 7 ट्रांसपायरेशन। आवर अनदर टॉपिक इज सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ट्रांसपायरेशन। सो डिफरेंट साइंटिस्ट गिविंग डिफरेंट ओपिनियन अबाउट द ट्रांसपायरेशन। सम आर सेइंग दैट ट्रांसपायरेशन इज वेरी यूजफुल टू द प्लांट्स, whereas others are saying that transpiration is very harmful for the plants. Even we all know about it that transpiration is a necessary evil. Understand? It means transpiration is good as well as harmful for the plants too. So transpiration is necessary evil, but here we discuss about the two aspects of transpiration. One is beneficial aspects. One is beneficial aspects of transpiration. So what are the beneficial aspects? The one is that ascent of sap. Ascent of sap. We already discussed about the ascent of sap, that mainly or major amount of water is transported with the help of passive absorption, which is possible only due to the transpiration pool. Okay, so here transpiration play an important role for the transportation of water into the plant. Second, if we discuss most or major amount of nutrients and water, major amount of nutrients, it may be minerals or water, transported due to the pressure created by the transpiration, that is suction pressure, okay, or suction pull. So that is, it is also beneficial that major amount of nutrients or minerals, they transported to the large plants in dissolved form through the pressure or the force created through the transpiration. If we discuss about the third thing, then transpiration cools down the leaves. Summer, we also having precipitation, and after precipitation our body became cool. So in the same way transpiration also cools down the leaves. Okay, due to that it also protects the chlorophyll, which is essential for the photosynthesis. And another aspect is that excess amount of water get removed. Okay, excess amount of water removed this process. So these are the important and beneficial aspects of transpiration. As one is ascent of sap, as we already discussed, that major amount of water transported to the passive transport where transpiration could play important role. Major amount of nutrient and water mineral dissolved form, they are transported to the transpiration. Transpiration cools down the leaves and it also protects the chlorophyll from damage, and excess amount of water is removed. Now we discuss about the harmful aspect. What is harmful aspect? Harmful aspect is this. We know that if we are adding 2 buckets of water, to the plant, then they utilized only half of bucket of water and another water is released as in the form of transpiration. Okay, so sometimes what happens, it causes wilting of the plants. Is that clear? Due to that what happens, sometimes the plant undergoes into the evident wilting condition, and at last may plant get dead. So this is the harmful impact or harmful aspect of the transpiration, that here because loss of water is takes place so much. Okay, dusra aap keh sakte hain wastage of water. ओके, सो सेकंड क्या कह सकते हैं आप, वेस्टेज ऑफ वाटर। व्हाई? बिकॉज़ 2 बकेट हम ऐड कर रहे हैं जिसमें से यूटिलाइज हो रही है ओनली हाफ बकेट ऑफ वाटर, और बाकी जो 1.5 है वो वेस्ट हो रहा है. ओके, और इसी प्रोसेस के ड्यूरिंग क्या हो सकता है, समटाइम जो प्लांट है वो बहुत ज़्यादा वाटर लॉस कर देता है, तो वो क्या होता है, एक एविडेंट विल्टिंग की स्टेज में चला जाता है, जिससे प्लांट की डेथ भी हो सकती है. इज दैट क्लियर? सो दीज आर अबाउट द बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट्स एंड हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ द ट्रांसपायरेशन. इज दैट क्लियर बेटा? अभी हम डिस्कस करेंगे हमारा नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज गटेशन. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो नाउ लेट वी विल डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज गटेशन. ओके, व्हाट इज गटेशन? सो द लॉस ऑफ वाटर थ्रू द लीफ मार्जिन इज नोन एज गटेशन. ओके, लॉस ऑफ वाटर थ्रू द लीफ मार्जिन और मार्जिन ऑफ द लीव्स, दैट इज नोन एज गटेशन. व्हाट हैपन इफ वी डिस्कस अबाउट द पोटैटो, ब्रायोफिलम एंड मैनी अदर प्लांट्स, सो दे शो द प्रोसेस ऑफ गटेशन. इट इज मेनली टेक्स प्लेस ड्यूरिंग द मॉर्निंग टाइम. ओके, एंड दिस गटेशन डू नॉट टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू द स्टोमेटा, बट इट इज टेक्स प्लेस थ्रू द स्पेशल पोर्स. द नेम ऑफ द पोर्स आर hydrophores. Okay, that is takes place through the small pores at the leaf margin, that is known as hydrophores, or these are known as differentiated stomata. Okay, generally these hydrophores do not having the mechanism of closing and opening. It means they do not show opening and closing. They all over, it means whole day and night they get opened. Okay, so the water exudes out. So water exudes out of the pores. Okay, and release outside, that is known as guttation. So especially in this, first we discuss about the structure of hydrophores and let me discuss how guttation takes place. So as it is visible to you that this is the stomatal chamber, or you can say that the water from where it should be exude out. Okay, below that some parenchyma cells are there, which are known as epithelium or epitherm tissue. This epitherm tissue adds up to the vascular endings. Okay, so generally what happens when the water absorbed through the vascular bundles of the leaf, which is more than the transpiration. As we know that most of the water transpires through the stomata, but sometimes when large amount of water absorbed through the tertiary elements or the vascular elements of the leaves, then this water produce or it creates a root pressure. Okay, it creates a root pressure when excess amount of water absorbed through the vascular tissue or tertiary elements of the leaves. Okay, then these jhalar vessels move the water up to the epitherm tissue. When this epithelium tissue or epitherm tissue gets saturated, then they exude the water through the substomatal chamber to the water stomatal chamber, and water released outside. The water which is released during the guttation, okay, the water which is released during the guttation, that is not pure water. It is not a pure water, but it contains some minerals and salts. It contains some minerals and salts. So I hope it is clear to you the structure of hydrophores. As these are visible to you, these are the leaf epithelium cells. Okay, these are tertiary elements or the vascular tissue of the leaf. This is the vascular ending. Okay, at the vascular ending, another tissues are there of parenchymatous cells, which are known as epithelium or epithelium tissue. They exude the water to the substomatal chamber, and then water released outside through the water stomatal chamber, or we can say that hydro pores, which are the small pores. So this is all over about the